Good day. Today I have with me Mr. K R Sekar, partner Deloitte, and the chairman of the Direct Taxes Expert Committee, Bangalore Chamber of Industry and Commerce. Mr. Sekar, pleasure to have you with us.
Thank you.
Well, you know, there's so much spoken about the budget, and what we would really like to know is, what are the policy implications when we talk about global investors? How does it positively affect them as they take India into the future?
Thanks, Amira, for this question. This budget has done very few things when it comes to the global investors. Of course, that sends a positive message, that sends the right signals. Number one, the abolition of Foreign Investment Promotion Board is a step in the right direction. The second one, clarifying that the indirect transfer provisions are not applicable for the FIIs, is a right step in the right direction. Third, extending the lower withholding tax of 5% for the debt raised from the masala bonds is a step in the right direction. So, from a policy perspective, these are all the three important tax proposals which would send a positive signal to the global investors. But what I would have been more happy is that one of the important challenges for the global investors is a long pending demand for the effective dispute resolution mechanism in India. And government, though last year brought to the dispute resolution settlement scheme, but that was not very success. So probably from a direct tax perspective, the government should have addressed the concerns on a dispute resolution. In my view, that should have been done. Had they done it, probably I would have said that it would have sent a right message for the foreign investors about the Indian government's seriousness on resolving the tax disputes.
Well, as you know, in any budgets, there are a lot of hits and misses. If I can ask you, you know, to outline, what are the misses in this budget from a tax perspective?
There are three important misses from my tax perspective. Number one, as I just explained, an effective dispute resolution mechanism is an important area. And unfortunately, though last year the scheme was announced, but the scheme was not successful. So in my view, the government should have made a strong attempt to address the entire dispute resolution mechanism. This has got important bearing because the dispute resolution panels, which is essential for resolving the controversies, are not successful in India. It is considered as a dispute confirmation panel rather than a dispute resolution panel. Therefore, the first miss was that addressing the dispute resolution system in India. The second miss, in my view, was the government promised the reduction of the corporate tax rate from 30% to 25%. And this year could have been an ideal one because you want to stimulate the economy, you want to revive the entire economy, you are looking for a big bang reform. So therefore, reduction in the rate from 30% to 25% would have been ideal at this point of time. Though it is reduced for the SMEs, but should have reduced for all the entire corporate taxes, so that corporates would have taken much more interest or keen on the reforms, because it would have been a good reform for the, what I would call, for the corporates. The third miss, in my view, was I thought the government was very keen on making manufacturing in India is very important. Though there is here and there are some proposals on revival of manufacturing sector for like additional incentive, reducing the rate of taxes for last year for startups and manufacturing at 25%. But I didn't see a big bang reform for manufacturing sector. Not only that, there is no incentivize for job creation. Though there is a very small amendment last year in the construct of additional salary paid for the additional workman, but lack of incentives for job creation, lack of incentives for the revival of manufacturing sector was another miss. The last miss which I would think about is that last year, the budget, Honorable Finance Minister made a statement while presenting the budget that the government is seriously considering the removal of discretionary powers vested with the income tax offices. I'm not so sure what is the status on that, whether the committee has worked out, submitted a report, what is the status on that. That has also not come. So these are all the four important misses from a tax perspective. Out of four, if any of two had been addressed, probably I would have rated a big bang reform on the direct tax side for the government.
Great. And finally, let's talk about the tax administration reforms. is it really relevant to India at this point of time?
Certainly it is very relevant at this point of time. The earlier government constituted a Tax Administrative Reform Commission and they gave a detailed report. There are a lot of aspects of the report are still yet to be implemented. And today we have disputes in India at every stage. There are huge money lying disputed in transfer pricing or any cross-border tax issues. And now we are coming out with a GAR, General Anti-Avoidance Regulations, Place Effective Management, various important international tax issues. Now to administer these issues, it needs a thorough administration, thorough tax department. And one of the big challenges in India is that we always have good laws, but very poor administration of the tax. And this is at high time that the government should implement the tax administrative reforms and make sure that not only in the letter, but also in spirit, that is a taxpayer friendly. When I mean taxpayer friendly, I am not asking to protect or shield the tax evaders. But when you interpret a law, there could be multiple positions. Please clarify those positions upfront so that the taxpayers can take a position accordingly rather than going for a dispute and trying to resolve the dispute for ages. So the biggest miss in my view was the tax administrative reform. And in my view, the government should focus on tax administrative reforms, because without a proper tax administration, whatever the good the laws will not be implemented in the right spirit. And that's my important point at this point of time.
R Sekar, we thank you for your time
today. Thank you so much, Samira.
And most importantly, your valuable inputs.
Thank you, Samira. Thanks a lot. Thank you so much.